Hey, my name is Jonathan, and today I'm going to tell you how to get a job in product or UX design, even if you don't have a portfolio. You know, a lot of people struggle with the idea that they have no experience, and yet they're being asked when they come in for a job interview to show what they've done in the past. Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how to get around that. Now, if you have any questions that I don't answer in this video, do let me know in the comments. I really want to know, and we answer everything. So you're looking for your first design job, and companies are looking for your portfolio, but you don't have a portfolio because you've basically never really done anything yet. Maybe you've studied, maybe you're looking for that experience that they're asking for you to have. It's kind of like one of these chicken or egg problems, right? Chicken and egg problems. The chicken and egg problem here is that these companies are asking you for something that you don't have yet. So really one of the first and best ways to get a job in a place, if you don't have a portfolio or if you don't have the experience, and especially, you know, in a lot of these companies, there's even a lot of competition for internships, is to try to volunteer at events that these companies are hosting. And these events are happening all the time, especially if they're big companies. And if they're not big companies, you know, and if they're not, if you're looking for like other places to volunteer at, go to meetup.com, go to Facebook, go to Eventbrite, type in, you know, design event in your city, and you're gonna find a lot of different types of events that you can volunteer at. And when you get the chance to volunteer, just absolutely over-deliver as much as you possibly can. Now, this is something that a lot of really smart people do when they want to start getting to know the people working at the company, because often that's the best way to get into a company without a portfolio, because you have access to the people working at this company and you're able to ask them like, hey, what would I need to get in here? What would I need to get an internship here? What would I need to get a junior position? And they're going to be able to tell you. But also, if you're extremely useful, if you're over the top useful when volunteering at one of these events, if you're the most useful person at the event. Now, that's really not difficult to do, because often people who volunteer really don't put a lot of effort in. And if you're the person who puts the most effort in, you will stand out. A lot of the people who got hired at AJ&Smart who work here today are people who turned up at our events or volunteered at events and just really outdid themselves. And it's not that they were the people who had the best portfolios or any portfolios, but they were the people that we were willing to give a chance because they were the people we knew if they would work here, they would be super proactive, super eager, super humble. The second thing you can do is called the canvas strategy. Now, the canvas strategy is one of the most powerful strategies for sort of getting what you want out of life. And it can really be used well for getting a job or for at least getting to know some great people within companies that could recommend you. Number one, it's about you figuring out, understanding where you are in sort of like the job food chain. And if you're at the start, then you're very, very low, which is totally fine. The second thing is like targeting a few people that you would like to get in touch with, people and companies that you want to work at, and figuring out what it is that would be valuable for them. There's two great ways to use the canvas strategy to get in touch and to get the attention of the people above you. One is really to connect them with other people who they might want to talk to. So you do the research and you figure out that, you know, it would be great if A spoke to B because A and B could help each other's careers. The second thing is actually to try to find inefficiencies in the way that they work today. One great example of that is Amr, who works at AJ&Smart right now, who's also often on our YouTube channel. He was in college when he got the job at AJ&Smart, so there was no portfolio or nothing like that, or at least I didn't see one. But the reason he got our attention is because he started doing the show notes for the podcast without asking us for like 6 months, until we were like, holy shit, like, who is this guy? And he got my attention. And when the team was looking for someone to, an intern to start, and the intern competition is crazy here, I was like, you should check out this guy called Amr. He did a really great job on these show notes. And that's a really, really great way to you know, make these people look good, make their lives easier. You want to start with the canvas strategy. You want to start with delivering as much value as possible. Do not start with saying, hey, can we meet up for a coffee? That is a disaster. Number three is using the least crowded channel to get in touch with people working at the companies that you're interested in, so that you can ask them questions about how to get a job in these companies. Now, what do I mean by the least crowded channel? Well, let's say that you want to work at Airbnb or something like that. Now, if you would email the person working in the recruiting department, or, you know, the head of design in one of the departments, the chances of you getting a reply is very low, and the chance or the chances of you getting a useful reply are pretty low. Let's say you manage to track down one of these people on Twitter or on Instagram, for example, that might not be a channel that a lot of people are contacting them on for jobs. And actually, this doesn't work anymore at AJ&Smart because I made an article about this before, but Instagram used to be AJ&Smart's least crowded channel, so nobody was contacting us there, so the people who really did contact us really stood out. So what you need to do is figure out the least crowded channel of the kind of companies that you want to work at, and you want to try to find the individuals in these companies who maybe get the least amount of information put at them. So for example, at AJ&Smart, it wouldn't be a good idea to contact me because I'm the person who gets the most email and the most people asking me, can they work here? But it would be a good idea to contact, you know, maybe a junior designer working in another department who would be super happy to chat with you and super happy to give you the tips on how to work here and the tricks. It's really crazy that people don't do this because you need to know the tips and tricks. You need to know how these companies recruit. If you don't know how AJ&Smart recruits, it's gonna be so hard to get a job here. It's gonna be so hard to stand out. But if you were able to get in touch with junior designers working here who you will have a chance to talk to, then you're already gonna get the insider knowledge on how to get a job at AJ&Smart. For example, use the least crowded channel. So what's the channel that almost no one else is using to contact this company? But also find out which people in the company would also have the like least amount of inbound traffic so they can actually answer your questions and actually deal with you. Now, finally, the portfolio problem. So it is sometimes good to have something to show. And especially, you know, if you come empty-handed, it might work if you use the other strategies and you just show that you're super valuable, you know, you're super humble, you're super eager. These things can work, but it does sometimes help to have some sort of a portfolio, even if none of it is real work. Because what it shows is that you're also interested in the kind of work that you're doing and you're teaching yourself and you're learning yourself in your spare time. So the type of portfolio that I would bring with me and present would be basically, you know, me doing redesigns of current products. I know a lot of designers would disagree with that, but I actually think it's a great way to show your design skills. Now, here's the interesting thing you need to understand. I'm not talking about just visual redesigns, like, oh, here's Twitter redesigned with a cool conversational interface. No, that's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about looking at the product that you wanna, you know, change or fix or update, and really creating a little case study on what you changed, why you changed it, and what the challenges were, what the product challenges were around why you changed it. Because there's nothing worse than seeing a portfolio which is just about, oh, well, I added boxes and shadows to this thing because I thought it looked ugly. If you're trying to work at a company and you're talking about, well, I changed this because I thought it looked ugly, no one's going to take you seriously. You have to think about, what was the challenge? Why did you redesign it? And what was difficult about redesigning it? What about your design doesn't work? That's super interesting for us to hear that you're also a person who is kind of, you know, self-aware about the things that you don't know. And actually, I'd add that as the last thing. Many times, designers who are new, straight out of college, are not, they don't realize that one of the best features of a person, like when I meet a new person, when I meet a new designer or someone who's still in college, the thing I want to see is that they're curious, that they're humble, and that they are aware that they don't know anything yet. That's actually pretty important. If I meet someone that they're being arrogant and they're saying, oh yeah, I know how to do that, yeah, I know how to do that, that's already a sign for me that this is a person who doesn't want to learn. I want to know that the person I'm talking to who's about to come into my company as a junior is going to be willing to admit that they don't know everything and willing to learn and really, really excited about learning. So for me, it's definitely not a good thing if someone comes in for a job interview and sort of acts as if they're arrogant and acts as if they know everything. Nobody likes this. Absolutely nobody likes this. It's about also being super, super aware about what you don't know and straight out saying, hey, look, I think one thing that I'm quite strong at is visual design. You know, I can recreate an Android app pretty quickly. I'm pretty fast in Figma, but I'll be honest with you, I'm not really up to date. And one thing I really want to get better at is product strategy, because I know that's super important. And I think that that's like an extremely important thing. F*** it, you know what? I do actually have another thing I want to say. If you're applying for a job at a company, and let's say even if you do have a portfolio, but remember, you're kind of at the bottom of the, you're at the bottom of the chain if you're coming in as a junior, if you're coming in as an intern. One thing that irritates me the most as somebody who hires people are people who don't do the research on the company that they're coming to interview at. The amount, like, I literally have people coming to AJ&Smart and they're like, oh my God, I want to work at AJ&Smart. Oh my God, yeah, blah, blah, blah. Here's what I do. And I'm like, oh, interesting. So did you see this thing on our YouTube channel? And they're like, oh, you have a YouTube channel? And then I'm like, okay, so you did no research into the company. You don't know anything about AJ&Smart. You don't know why you want to work here. You just sent us like 20, you sent 20 emails to the agencies all over Berlin, and that's what's happening. No company likes this. You have to do your research. You have to try to understand what the challenges at that company you're about to join are. There's a million people, you know, signing up to be, get interviewed. You need to stand out by being someone who really, really, really does their research, like as much as possible. You know, if I was going to go work in a specific team at Google, I would spend days doing as much research as I can, because it actually shows respect. And there's nothing that shows a lack of respect like not doing the research and asking questions that maybe out the fact that you didn't really check up on the company. You know, if you go to for an interview at Airbnb and you, you know, ask a question, which is something that they posted in their blog last week on their design blog, that's not going to be something that this hiring manager really likes the sound of, right? It can sound like you're just interviewing at 20 other places and you really don't care. So that's a lot of different things. You don't, and to, maybe to finish it up to say, you know, it's not super important to have a perfect portfolio. The idea is really to try to get a job, whether it's an internship or whether it's a junior role. That's how you start building your portfolio. But even that first step from zero, you know, from college or from self-learning, getting into the company, you do need to have a couple of tactics. You do need to be humble. You do need to be eager. You do need to be excited about working at these companies. You do need to do your research. You have to find the least crowded channel to chat to people working at the company and figure out what it is. How do you get in there? Put a little bit of effort into it. And it is easy to stand out because most people do not put in the effort. So I hope this is a little bit motivational for you. You know, if you're a student, if you're just starting out, or if you're jumping careers from maybe graphic design to UX design, do be humble, be honest about what you don't know, and try to stand out. I hope you liked this video. If you did, this is a different style of video. This is just me sitting here with a camera. I hope you liked it. If you did, give it a like. Ask questions in the comments below about, you know, how to get a job in design. If you're interested in more videos like this, we've got over 150 videos on all the different types of things you can possibly imagine relating to UX design and product design. We've also got a podcast that comes out every Monday morning. It's called The Product Breakfast Club. If you're interested in the product design world, definitely listen to that. A lot of career advice as well. And every single day on Instagram, we're posting stories from inside the AJ&Smart Design Studio. Thanks so much for your time and have a great day. Hey, my name is Jonathan, and today in this... Find new... Okay. There's two great ways to...